Let's just begin by closing our eyes. And in that space, do something very, very simple. We want to just focus on our own breath, make it a little deeper than we normally breathe in, so we're conscious of it. It all begins with simply giving the benefit of the doubt. We do this because that lower brain function, that animal fight or flight, emotional brain, mid and lower brain response, we go into hyperdrive. Our pulse increases. The blood moves from the vital organs out to our extremities to prepare for fight or flight. Our pores open to cool us off. Pupils dilate to allow in more light. And the blood, rather than moving towards the brain, moves towards the extremities to ready for that fight or flight process. When we get triggered, it's by something somebody says, by something they do, by something that we imagine that they've done, or that we imagine that they've thought. And our breath becomes shorter, much more rapid. If we speak, our voice becomes much louder. And like our breath, we speak much quicker. And if we're in that state, no matter what words we say, the other person's going to feel it. And they're going to mirror that back because of these mirror neurons. Their breath is going to become shorter. Their temper is going to become shorter. The blood is going to be shunted away from their brain to their extremities. So they're ready for fight or flight. And when the blood leaves the brain in that manner, we can't think straight. We can only think of one thing: to protect ourselves. To fight or to flee. And in modern days, what that means is to verbally attack or to withdraw and essentially become the victim, become scarred. If we're never able to surrender that association we make with this event. So where we can take control of this and let it go and call upon that higher nature, first off, just with our mere breath, slowly breathing, stopping consciously that rapid breath, that shallow breath, making slow, deep breath. Not responding to the person by shooting from the hip, telling them the way it is, but rather just holding the space initially, hearing what they have to say, hearing, as what Ben said so beautifully, what our soul on the deepest level wants us to hear. Wants us to be. Our soul, our spirit doesn't have these issues. It's just in the maze, the configuration of these 100 billion neurons we have in our brains, these patterns that we form from past experiences that we retain, that if we've never surrendered, actually begin to form our thoughts, our beliefs, and our responses, our behavior. So in holding the space, just breathing as we're listening to the other person, counting, looking them in the eye, which is neither fight nor flight, it's just presence. When we look somebody in the eye, that's just presence. So this is the first stage of giving somebody the benefit of the doubt. And the benefit of the doubt is the negation of the assumption that either they had malintent with what they said, that possibly the way we took it, it's giving ourselves the benefit of the doubt, that the way we took it may have been our own reaction, something triggered inside of us from 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 years of history of building up these patterns. Most likely, that is it. It's the way we're taking it. Or if something had been triggered in them, maybe not even by anything we said or did, but they just had a bad day. They had an unexpected bill. Somebody blasted them, as we're talking about preventing ourselves from doing. We just happen to be the next person they come across. And so the tone of their voice has nothing to do with us. It just has to do with the bad day that they're having. So through this phenomenal other process inside the human being of mirror neurons, if we give them the chance to mirror that higher state, that surrender, that slower breath, that openness to another reality, a higher reality, this is the ultimate act of grace. And not just for them. Most importantly, because we've got to live with ourselves, not with them. Even if somebody's a spouse or a partner, we live with ourselves 24 hours a day. But we give ourselves the grace by giving them grace, giving them the opportunity to realign with that slower, more parasympathetic, what's called the parasympathetic nervous system, the more relaxed state of the nervous system, to align with that as opposed to that fight or flight, sympathetic, adrenaline, prehistoric aspect of our nervous system. And suddenly, we no longer feel like the victim when we realize that this person meant us no harm, or that they're sorry that they came across the way they did. A famous guru said, regret follows anger. That higher part of ourselves realizes that that is not who we truly are. The whole purpose that we've come here for, if you really want to get down to the meaning of life, is to realize that we are the sons and daughters of the Creator, Him, Herself. that not only are we made in the image of the Creator, in our highest level of functioning, like the great masters, whether we're talking about Jesus Christ, Buddha, Nelson Mandela, the modern day saints, the Dalai Lama, Martin Luther King. We revere those people because they did rise up to that higher and higher nature of getting beyond the reactive brain, beyond reaction. And it all begins with simply giving the benefit of the doubt. Using the five phases, incrementally building up to speaking our truth if necessary, but in the far majority of cases, never even needing to get to that point when we learn how to do these other phases. Living more in harmony, living more in peace. Every relationship, personal, professional, and otherwise, every relationship, possible conflict or confrontation or upset, now suddenly this magical vehicle to return back to that higher self by giving the benefit of the doubt using these five phases. The actual movement away from that higher self, now the vehicle to return to it and remember who we are, the beautiful daughters and sons of the Creator, made in her, his image. We're just taking a slow deep breath again. And let it out. Do that a few more times, just on your own. Just realize, so we are. This is who we ultimately are. So when you're ready, you can slowly open your eyes.